Good evening. It is my distinct pleasure to welcome you here tonight for one of our favorite concerts. For those of you who do not know me, my name is Lindsay Williams, and I'm the director of bands here at Illegal Free Academy. And welcome. As you take a moment to notice the exits around you and silence your devices, I would like to thank the following people for their enduring support of our schools. We could not be here tonight without our administration, Principals Ken Francisco, Phil Schofield, Superintendent of Schools, Corey Green, our Board of Education and their President, Gene Civic, our Music Booster Club, and our Theater Manager, Mr. Hall, our OA faculty and staff members, especially our music teachers here helping us tonight, our music families, and of course, our musicians. In addition to these phenomenal folks, tonight we have a special composer and community service members here in celebration of an innovative endeavor, who will boldly share our collective stories and bring history to life. So, as I introduce the sixth grade band, did you know that the word innovate comes from the Latin innovatus, which means to renew or restore? Tonight, every single one of our bands will literally and metaphorically breathe new life into well-known narratives of gnome attacks, I hear. Is that right, sixth grade? Yes, and pirate caves. They will remind us of some dark beginnings, correct, seventh and eighth grade band? Yes. And many future dance celebrations, am I right? Oh yes, very good. All right, but remember, what you see on stage begins with those of you sitting in the audience. Tonight is first and foremost, at its very core, our Thanksgiving to you. So please welcome me in join me in welcoming to our stage every single member of the sixth grade concert band and their remarkable director, Miss Teresa Desker.
I bet you can't guess why, so I apologize if I'm a little quieter. We are so lucky to have the most fantastic team of music educators, many of whom are helping backstage or in the audience tonight. The piece you just heard was called Pirate's Cave, not Pirate's Cove. There is a different band piece with that same name. I said it one time in rehearsal and I have not been allowed to forget it. Isn't that right, sixth grade? Yeah. The group you see right on stage right now is sixth grade band. And for many of them, this is their very first concert at the middle school. These students have done a fantastic job this year, and they are truly a joy to work with. We always laugh a lot together, which for me is the best part of any rehearsal. The transition to middle school music classes can be tough, but they have been so well prepared by their fantastic OES and AES music teachers. During our dress rehearsal last week, the students wanted to make sure I provided you with some context for our next selection, entitled Attack of the Garden Gnomes. The composer writes about how in some parts of the world, there is a tradition of pranking your neighbors by kidnapping the garden gnomes from their lawn and taking them on vacation with you. You might take pictures of the gnomes in front of famous landmarks and send them home. So he imagines this piece as the response if the gnomes ever decided to band together and fight back. You're gonna hear some unusual percussion instruments, the sound of marching, and even perhaps the gnomes themselves. Here is Attack of the Garden Gnomes.
Thank you.
So named because they play pieces that use a very symphonic sound, so lots of different instruments, usually a couple more parts than we have in sixth grade. Our first piece was called the Victor's March. Marches are so very important to the band tradition, dating all the way back to Sousa and the military bands, and they get us ready for marching band and parades in high school. Up next, we have a work called Dance Celebration, which was written in honor of the composer's two daughters at their first dance recital. We open with a lyrical-sounding section for the ballerina, and then continue to a more upbeat style for the contemporary dancer. Sadly, Robert W. Smith, the composer who wrote this piece, passed away earlier this fall. He was an incredibly prolific composer for band, and had a gift for writing music that was both approachable and fun. How many of you have played a band instrument at some point in your life? Raise your hand. I would be willing to bet most of you have probably played something by Robert W. Smith if you've played your instrument in the last 25 or so years. So we're thinking of him tonight as we play this piece. And we hope that you enjoy Dance Celebration as much as we did learning it.
Thank you.
final piece before we turn it over to the fabulous OFA concert band. It's entitled Dark Beginnings by Mr. Randall Sandridge himself, a very popular name in the band world right now. In the program notes, I'm going to share some of them with you. Sandridge writes, "Occasionally I would have my students do a review marathon in which we would play back through old lines of our beginning band books. Whenever I would call up Hot Cross Buns, Mary Had a Little Lamb, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, and all these old favorites, there would be groans, and they would say the songs were not cool." He writes, "This always broke my heart, because I would remember the first days we would play these songs, and the looks of excitement on their faces." And I'm sure all of you who have had a fourth or fifth grade band student at home remember hearing these very popular tunes, perhaps hundreds and hundreds of times. He then talks about how this inspired him to write a piece using these so-called beginner songs, but making them cool again. He takes snippets of these popular childhood melodies, and he has made them sound intense, a little bit spooky, and has made them trickier to play. So we've had to learn some new notes, some new rhythms, some new articulations, all on these songs that they've known for a long time. You're never too old to go back to your roots and pay homage to what got you started. So we hope you enjoy our rendition of Dark Beginnings.
Thank you.
Hello again. We shall continue our portion of the program by sharing the stuff, strength, and steel it takes to forge ideas into actuality, the heart of STEAM education, which tonight is all about. Much of that being teamwork. It gives me no greater pleasure than to introduce you our current student teacher from Ithaca College, Miss Mitchell, and the Wego Free Academy Band. Is made possible in part with very special funds from the NISCA's decentralization program administered regionally in our area of New York by the Arts Council of the Southern Finger Lakes. We are so, so happy for all their support of this special innovative project. As we are supremely grateful for them, of course. So since its inception, this has been a piece about innovation, over the pandemic, our composer, Chris Bill, who is here with us tonight, helped us with our first commission and the Arts Council as well, and the host team also. Through our research at that time, we learned that about 100 years ago, nearly every fire department had a band, and we wanted to rekindle this relationship. Parallelly, we wanted to do the same in our own music world. We wanted to wash away boundary lines between concert band and rock band, between so-called old music and new. So we asked Chris if he could do that for us, and he said, of course. And he added some drum sets and some electric bass and guitars and new percussion instruments and electronic percussion instruments to the classic band instrumentation to tell a story of heroic rebirth. Actually, can we see some of those? So, Ruben, can you play a little bit of what you're going to play for us on the synth? Some of the sound. Now, you don't usually hear that in concert band. And Cindy, can you use the marching machine a little bit so they can see this? My husband Dan Williams made this for us. Awesome. And then Cindy, can you use the synth pad for us as well? Nice. All right, I think you've heard drum sets and guitars and basses before. We're going to use all of those exciting new colors in our piece tonight. So Chris and the members of the host team are with us here tonight for premiere, which sixth graders, if you don't know, that means this piece has never been performed before, ever. So you are the first people to hear. Aren't you excited? Yeah, very good. So we are super excited. And so at this time, also, I'm going to invite to the stage members of the host team to share a few updates with you about the project, which they're really sinking their teeth into just this week. It should be finished up, within the next year or so. And they're going to show you some visuals about the work that they've been doing and the historic steamer that they have been restoring. So can I invite Pat Gavin to the stage to speak on behalf of the host team?
It's great to be with you this evening. We're very excited. How about a big round of applause for all the musicians so far? As Mr. Williams said, I'm Pat Gavin. I'm with the Owego host team, also the historian for the Owego Fire Department. And gosh, dating myself, almost 30 years ago, I was a percussionist in the Owego Appalachian band specializing in the triangle. So. Anthrax and Mildred, if my memory serves me correct. But as Mrs. Williams noted, the Owego Fire Department is very blessed to have a premier piece of American fire service history in our 1866 Amiskeg steam fire engine. So for those of you who aren't familiar with the history of the fire service, way back when our country was founded, folks would put out fires with buckets. They were called bucket brigades. And can you imagine being out on a cold evening like this? Every household in town was assigned their own bucket. So when a fire happened, Owego was fortunate to have a fire bell. Other places just used church bells. The church or fire bell would ring and everybody would come running to the fire with their bucket. And they would set up these bucket brigades and put out the fire. They weren't necessarily putting out the fire, rather than trying to contain it so the whole town didn't burn down. So as technology evolved, they went from bucket brigades to what they called hand pumpers. So folks would get on what were called brakes, these big handles, and they would have to manually pump the water to put out the fire. And it would take roughly 50 to 100 people to do that. So over in England in 1829, they invented this thing called the steam fire engine. And the steam fire engine made firefighting a lot more efficient. So you went from 50 to 100 firefighters actually running the apparatus to down to two. You had a person at the pump controls, and you had a person feeding the fire, which created the steam, which runs the steam fire engine. So Owego obtained its steam fire engine back in 1866. That's, my Owego math serves me correctly, about 157 years ago. And we've been fortunate enough to have that in the Owego Fire Department up until this day. And that steam fire engine actually worked and operated up until the late 1980s, at which time it was the oldest operating steam fire engine in the country. But then the boiler started to wear out and was taken out of service. So in comes the Wego hose team a couple years ago. It was suggested to us, hey, you just finished restoring the Baker's Fireman's Fountain in the courthouse square. Why don't you take on the steam fire engine and restore that and make it the oldest operating again in the country? So some $60,000 later, we're over budget, underfunded, behind schedule, but there is light at the end of the tunnel. The steam fire engine is in Hope, Maine, at a place called Firefly Restorations. It'll be mounted back, and the boiler's been completely rebuilt. It'll be mounted back on its frame actually next week, and we hope to have it back in its hometown here in Wego in the spring of 24. And we'll certainly be having it all in the community and displayed, and you all will be able to see once again the oldest operating steam fire engine in the country, so we're excited about that. In addition to that, you may have seen some activity on North Avenue next to the fire station. We're building its own what we're calling Steamer House, which will showcase the steam fire engine. The building will have all glass windows, so anybody will be able to go down North Avenue and see the steam fire engine in its steamer house in its glory. We also, speaking of bells, took out the bell that was in the top of Central Fire Station, and that bell will be put in the steamer house, and it'll ring much like it did way back then. We're gonna try and get it to ring during daylight hours, so it'll function again too. So that project, like Lindsay said, started this week, and hopefully the building will be erected in the next 2 weeks, so when you're on North Avenue and you see that new wood structure, you'll know what's going on down there. So we're all excited about that. Speaking of Mr. Fabricius, there's a bunch of vibrant organizations in town, and certainly the Wego Appalachian Music Department is one of them. And I'll give you a story that relates to Mr. Fabricius and this project. So Firehouse Subs out of Ithaca called us, and they had a new concept. They have their stores, and I think one's in Syracuse and the other one's in Ithaca. They wanted to create a mobile food truck to go to different fire departments and help raise money, and they heard that the Wego Hose Team was good at raising money, so they called and said, hey, we got a deal for you. We'll bring our mobile food truck down to Wego. We'll test it out in Wego, but with one caveat. We don't have the staff to man it. So I'm thinking to myself, and I'm thinking how I'm gonna ask my wife this, I'm gonna be manning a mobile food truck at Wego Central Fire Station for a week. So they brought it down, we manned it, but one of our first customers was Mr. Fabricius. And he had just retired, and I had talked to him about his retirement and what he was gonna do, and he was gonna continue to be involved in the music program. And I could tell by the gleam of his eye that he knew that he was passing the torch on to somebody who was gonna certainly carry it on, and that's no other than Mrs. Wayne. So a big round of applause for her. So we partnered with the band on their first commission. The band has played in our parades. The band has played at some fundraisers for us. It's a partnership we're very proud of. We wish to continue. One final note I'll mention to all the budding musicians here. This is quite the feat. You have created your own piece of music. Now you're going to play it all for us for the first time. Music is a very powerful thing, you all. I'll give you an example. 15 years ago in November, I was at a watering hole in our nation's capital in Washington, D.C., and I was playing music on a jukebox. And my wife asked the bartender, who's playing that music? And the bartender said, oh, Gavin's playing the music. So he introduced us, and 15 years later, my bride's in the audience, and my three beautiful children. So music is a very powerful thing. You united us, and you're showing that off tonight. And I'm sure I was playing probably the Rolling Stones, who were in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, on that jukebox on that night. Well, I would like to say that you all musicians tonight are a Wego Rock and Roll Hall of Famers, and we can't wait to hear this new piece. So thank you all, I appreciate it, and Mrs. Williams, we really love this program.
Did you want to say anything, Mr. Bill? Oh, all right, thank you. All right, hey, Ben, can we give another round of applause to Mr. Bill? There's nothing. Thank you for being here. Fantastic. This is not the sort of thing that you see everywhere. I can't impress upon you how just special it is to have a composer like Chris Bell, who also, by the way, is right from Endicott, New York. And so he's just like, we're just among so much talent right here. And so I'm hoping that you leave tonight feeling like, wow, OWIGO is just one of the best places that I could have just landed, right? We're so lucky to be here with each other. So thank you again. Go ahead. Being thankful and Thanksgiving. Our next piece is just plain fun. It's another sort of innovation, a fractured fairy tale, right? An unlikely but lovely combination of Halloween and Christmas. So we figured a Thanksgiving concert would be the perfect place for it. So here is a little Nightmare Before Christmas.
Thank you.
piece, of course, we invite any OFA band alumni and family to the stage for our tradition that my mentor joyfully started, and one I hope that we have joyfully expanded. As a reminder that those who love us never leave us, and that once you are in the band, you are always in our band. So we hope that it continues to grow and innovate far past our own time here. Alumni, yep, find a seat. Welcome home. Any seat is fine. There we go. See, make space at the table. They're so good, you know? Just do it. Because there's no OFA without all of you. Even though there's no you in OFA, I know that, but that's all right. So Madison Mitchell is going to conduct Slayer Ride, and I'm going to join the table too. Present and obviously revitalize our future. So may your holiday season be filled with renewal And thank you for celebrating tonight with us. Safe travels home, everyone.